Liver tests, or liver enzymes, sometimes incorrectly called liver function tests, refer to AST, ALT, ALP, and may include GGT. Abnormal values are often found on routine blood tests and indicate liver injury. Bilirubin, albumin, and prothrombin time, or INR, are better tests of the function of the liver and are the LFTs. A patient with abnormal liver tests can present in a number of different ways, or can be completely asymptomatic. While a clinical assessment focused on risk factors and stigmata of liver disease remains key, the pattern of liver enzyme elevation will guide the differential and workup. First, take a look at which enzymes are elevated. A rise in ALT and/or AST that is proportionally higher than the ALP indicates a hepatocellular pattern of injury, while a rise in ALP, confirmed to be from the liver by an abnormal GGT, indicates a cholestatic pattern. Second, what is the pattern? If the pattern of injury is cholestatic, that is, the ALP and GGT rise are greater than the ALT or AST, you will need to obtain a dedicated ultrasound of the liver and biliary tree to look at the bile ducts. Dilated bile ducts indicate extrahepatic cholestasis, and an ERCP may be needed for diagnosis and therapy. Normal bile ducts indicate intrahepatic cholestasis, and a liver biopsy may be required if the cause is not identified by history or other investigations such as the anti-mitochondrial antibody or MRCP. If the pattern of injury is hepatocellular, that is, the ALT or AST rise is greater than the ALP and GGT, determine the severity using the ALT level. An ALT of less than 300 is mild, and 300 to 1,000 corresponds to moderate liver disease. These can be acute or chronic, and unfortunately, the differential diagnosis is broad. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, NAFLD, is the most common cause of mild elevation. Alcoholic liver disease is associated with an AST that is often 2 to 3 times higher than the ALT, but alcohol or NAFLD rarely cause the ALT to be greater than 300. Further evaluation and testing will be guided by your history and clinical suspicion. If the ALT is greater than 1,000, there is severe liver injury, which is always acute and symptomatic. These patients are at high risk of acute liver failure. If you see these values, think and test for the following: drugs, especially acetaminophen overdose, viruses, hepatitis A through E, HSV, CMV, and VZV, ischemia from Budd-Chiari syndrome or shock, autoimmune hepatitis, Wilson's disease, and if the patient is pregnant or recently postpartum, HELLP syndrome or acute fatty liver or pregnancy. A quick recognition and diagnosis can guide appropriate management in these patients.